idea.
You think you're so great. Strutting around. Hey, mister. I just want to be left alone, all right?
A sentiment I'm familiar with. Fair enough, kid.
Holding hands.
Get this off me. I'm going numb. Keep at it. Oh, God. You did it. Praise Jesus. Oh, God. I gotta grab something for the blood. Thank you. Oh, I was done for. You saved me. Thank you. Take something from my back for the trouble, though. I'm gonna take a minute now.
Here, drink this for the pain.
Oh, God, yes. My leg feels like it's on fire. And the thing, I almost didn't bring the trap.
Yeah. Imagine this is here by accident. Ugh. Come on, girl. Yep. Come on, girl. Yep. Yeah. Come on. Yep. 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 Thank you.
Can't you see I'm tracking game here?
These droppings are fresh.
Okay, sure. Good luck.
Thought I saw you over there.
Let's go, girl.
Yep.
Easy, girl. Let's go, girl.
Yep.
Yep. Get up. Yeah. Mr. Thomas Downs?
Yep, that's me.
You owe me money.
Oh, no. I'm...
Oh, come here, you maggot.
Please, sir. I'll...
Really? Threaten me, would you?
Please. I have a family, sir. Please.
I don't care about your family. Why'd it have to come to this, huh?
Believe me, sir. I didn't want this either.
You ain't such a do-gooder, are you? If you're running out on debts...
I'm not running anywhere. I'm doing my best for you. If you want the money, you'll have to wait.
You are a slippery little bastard. But I got you now.
Please!
Strauss told me you needed a beating. You saying he was right?
What will that solve? Please. Please, no.
You borrowed money from my business partner, Herr Strauss. You owe him. You took the money. He wants it back. What's not to understand? Where's our money?
I don't have it.
Sell your place.
We already owe more than it's worth.
Then sell your wife, or your family, or something. We ain't your idea of charity. Is that clear?
Thomas!
What are you looking at?
Thomas!
I said, what you looking at, woman?
My husband isn't well. If we could just have more...
Like I said, we ain't nobody's idea of charity. Get us the money. Missing your tree yet?
I feel like chopping it down.
Ah, how did you get on?
Not so good. He's almost dead. And they seem more or less destitute. You were a fool for lending them the money.
I don't believe for 1 minute that you ever made it to Australia.
Well, man, you'd be right. I never did. But I tried. I made it as far as Chicago. Chicago ain't nowhere near Australia.
No. You'll work it out, Dutch. You always do.
Good morning, Arthur. See you on them kangaroos.
So, I found you a pipe.
Hello, Reverend.
Well, will you look at that? You want these? I stole them anyway.
Sure, why not? Hey, Bill.
Did you find much in the O'Driscoll's cabin?
We did all right out of it. Just no comb. Well, I should get back to it.
All right.
okay, girl. Yeah. Stay out of trouble. Poor bastard.
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb you, ma'am. Is Mrs. Linton in?
I'll go see. Mrs. Linton? A caller for you.
Hello, Arthur.
Mary?
I heard you and your friends was around.
Okay. Where's what's his name?
Died.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, me too. Happened a while ago. Pneumonia.
Bad business.
Sure.
So, you've been... you've been made a widow and you come here looking for me, is that it?
No, ain't like that, Arthur.
Ah, okay.
My family. I need your help.
You mean the family that always looked down on me? You want me to help?
It's my little brother, Jamie.
I always liked Jamie, at least compared to the rest of them.
He's broken Daddy's heart.
Daddy has a heart?
Don't make me beg you, Arthur.
My money, my life, me. I wasn't good enough.
I'm sorry. We need your help real bad. Little Jamie's joined the Chelonians, that strange religious order.
Good for him.
They're quite mad, Arthur. They'll kill him. You're the only person he'd listen to.
So, I'm too rough to marry into your family, but it's okay to ask me to help in saving your family.
I'm sorry. I understand if you don't want to help me, but... but I think of you often.
Long time ago now.
I'm begging you, Arthur.
I say let Jamie live Jamie's life and not the nightmare that his daddy dreamed up for him.
Jamie's so innocent, Arthur. Please, Arthur. Will you help me?
Where is he?
Somewhere out near Carmody Dell, I think. The rancher there said he...
up and died on me, twisted my ankle something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Yeah, sure. Hop on.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. You know Emerald Ranch? Mind taking me there?
Yep. Sure.
Glad I ran into you. Huh. I raised that horse, you know. Raised it since it was just a foal.
Oh, losing a horse is hard. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah. That horse did right by me. Better than my husband, truth be told. that fool. Always complaining, but does he do something about it? Man barely lifts his hand to wave the flies away, aside from to lift a drink, of course. Marriage, for me, has been nothing but trouble. But Biscuit, he was a fine animal. Loyal, smart, brave. Didn't take no guff, not from no one. Had one of them mountain boys pull a gun on me once. I was riding up near the Dakota and had stopped by a nice warm patch. Must have dozed off, but I wake up and find some nasty piece of work pointing a rusty shotgun straight at me. Well, he gets wheezing on and I must have made some sort of noise, because the next thing I know, Biscuit had nipped his ear clean off. Kicked his hide too as he was hollering away. Didn't think a man could run so fast.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, had a good laugh on that one. I tell the husband, what does he do? Should have never gone over there, honey, he says. Gee, thanks.
So, you live at Emerald Ranch then?
For the time being. I was looking for work. They was looking for some help with the gardens. If I waited any longer for my husband to put food on the table, I'd have died of starvation. Oh, we're getting close now.
Yeah.
Here we go. This is great. This was kind of you, mister. Please, take this as my way of thanking you. Appreciate it. What a lousy
day. Nice talking
day.
With you, ma'am. Good luck to you.
You too. All the best.
Yep. Yep.
Okay. Let's go, girl.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, girl.
And what is Chelonianism? No less than the recent rediscovery of theology.
Gentlemen!
Shell of safety.
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 Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. The path to truth.
Well, I mean, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I'm still searching, I guess.
We are all searching. Chelonianism is about searching. What do we search for, do you think?
I don't know. Safety? Safety and meaning?
Jamie knows the truth. But of course, you may speak with him.
Exactly. If your teachings are so great, what harm can I do?
I'm not coming with you, Arthur!
Just come and speak with Mary, then make up your mind!
Chelonian.
Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help!
Come on, Jamie, your sister's worried about you!
You pop up out of nowhere?
They're just using you, telling you what you want to hear.
What the hell do you know about it, Arthur?
Just stop and let's talk about this.
Oh, Arthur, you're slipping in your old age.
Just hold up a minute. Come on, you ain't stupid. You can see this is crazy.
You're the crazy one. I was doing
do, Jamie? Live the rest of your life in the mountains with those people?
They're my friends! If you don't leave me alone, I'll shoot you! I swear it!
What are you talking about? You ain't no killer!
You don't know who I am!
Yeah.
Move! Move! Oh my God!
Oh God! What are you doing?
Please, Arthur! I'm a man now! I found something! A calling!
You're just a kid! You're making a big mistake!
I'm not taking advice from you! You're an outlaw! You leave me alone! They're good people! I'm warning you, Arthur Morgan! Leave me alone!
Please, kid. Put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!
Now calm down! Let's go see your sister.
Okay. Okay.
It's okay, kid.
Have I been a terrible fool, Arthur?
I don't know. I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know, there ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Oh, no. That's all a long time ago, son. Idiot. Yeah.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you. You didn't try to kill yourself.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Chelonia, though? Really? You'd fall for that?
They were very nice to me. They're decent.
I'm sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to believe that there might be something good coming my way one day. Guess that's dead in the water.
With the turtles.
Shut up. All Father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore.
Forgive me, but your father's a bully and a coward. Don't listen to him.
Hey, don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's a good father, nice man.
He won't be happy I saw you.
Please send him my worst regards.
The thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Come on, that ain't true. Tell me something you like. Don't think too hard.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Okay. I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something, but all right, go work in an orchard then.
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did. Here we are. She must be waiting inside.
We going in then?
Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed. But I'll come home for you.
My boy. My sweet boy. Come on.
Oh, Arthur. Thank you. Thank you.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur. And you. Oh, you'll never change. I know that.
I feel like the luckiest man alive, and I feel like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else alive. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow I imagine I should...